Hello students, today I will discuss one topic. That is soil. Soil is made the first appearance as early as in the year of 1835. And these were mounted on rail track and powered by steam engine at that time. The soils were slow in action and were very clumsy. As time passed, they became stronger, faster and lighter and left the rail to move on crawler tracks and sometimes on rubber tires. Soil can be visualized on the following three structural divisions: the top of revolution unit in the head, the mounting or travel unit at the leg, and other attachments are the arm and hands. So let's come to the general construction of this shovel. A shovel consists of a bucket rigidly attached to the end of a steel structure known as a depository. Which can play forward and backward is held in position by a cable on the bucket side, while it is supported by a pinion on the other. The pinion and the rack on the underside of the deepest stick is in constant mesh. These pinions are held in pinion on a heavy structural member known as boom. The boom is provided as its underside with the turntable, while the top end of the boom is held in position by means of a cable known as the boom post cable. The superstructure or the turntable support all the equipment necessary to operate this way, including the operators, control room, mechanism for hoisting, swinging and traveling of the swing. The crawler mechanism supports the whole shovel and also provide motion to the shovel for traveling, including the steering of the machine as well. These shovels can be classified or classified consideration of the following factors, that is working agent, bucket size and working mechanism. So let's start. According to the working agents, shovels are classified in three ways. One is diesel shovel, and the second one is electric shovel, and the last one is hydraulic shovel. According to the bucket size, the shovels are three types. One is commercial type power shovel, where bucket capacity in the range of 0.275 cubic meter to 1.8 cubic meter. Second one is very mine type shovel, where bucket size is varied in between 1.8 cubic meter to 15 cubic meter. And the last one is large quarry mine type shovel, where the bucket size is vary in between 15 cubic meter to 75 cubic meter and more. And according to the working mechanism, they are divided into two ways. First one is a rope shovel, and the second one is non-rope shovel. In the rope shovel, the front attachment such as bucket, depository, booms are controlled by rope, while in the non-rope shovel, they are controlled by the piston and cylinder
arrangement. So student, let's start with the
diesel shovel. This is the oldest type of shovel used in open cast project. Various designs are available nowadays. The figure shows the general view of the shovel, which consists of the following units. First one is prime mover. Here a diesel engine is used. Second one is power transmission system, including crowd and hoist mechanism, travel mechanism, and swing mechanism. Next one is undercarriage unit. And the last one is front attachment. So let's start with this. So first one is, here we start with the power transmission system. The power transmission system, the engine deliver power to three different shafts through a torque converter and the first chain sprocket. The shafts are, number one is crowd and bucket shaft or CBT shaft. Second one is boom hoist shaft or BH shaft. Number three is swing and propel shaft or CP shaft. So let's start with the crowd and bucket hoist shaft. This is a crowd and bucket hoist shaft. The crowd and bucket hoist shaft is placed at the furthest end from the engine. The rotation of the swing, and propel shaft and crowd and bucket hoist shaft remain in the same direction as that of the engine shaft. The bucket is raised by engaging the drum bent clutch, which connected the freely mounted rotating hoist drum with the shaft CBH. If the bucket has to be stopped or held in a raised position, the drum bent clutch is disengaged and the brake is applied simultaneously. The bucket is usually allowed to fall down by its own weight, and thus speed is adjusted by the brake. The dipstick and the bucket are forced forward, that is crowding, which is down by engaging the bent clutch to the shaft. When the two sprocket begins to rotate with the shaft, one of the sprocket of the swing sprocket is connected to the spinner shaft. These are two crowd pinion mounted on the shipper shaft, which are in constant mesh with the dipstick rack. If the engine shaft rotates clockwise, the crowd pinion will also rotate in a clockwise direction, thereby producing the crowd motion of dipstick. Next is boom hoist shaft. To lift the boom, a jaw clutch is engaged with the free boom drum and the cone clutch is engaged with the boom hoist shaft, thereby hoisting the boom. The boom drum is prevented from rotation by disengaging the cone clutch and simultaneously applying the brake on the drum as provided. Lowering of the boom is achieved by its own
web and is controlled by the brain. Next is swing and propeller shaft. The swing and propeller shaft is connected to the engine shaft, which directly receives power from the engine crankshaft through the thrust reduction. Two cone clutch L and R are mounted on this shaft. By engaging this clutch, level gear L and R can be made active respectively. If the right hand side clutch R is engaged only, the swing and propeller vertically shaft rotates in a proper direction, thereby enabling a mechanism on mechanism to swing or travel is on one direction. When the left hand side clutch L is engaged, the swing and propeller vertical shaft rotates counterclockwise, which helps to swing and travel the opposite direction. Power from the swing and propeller vertical shaft is taken into the swing shaft at the top of the top end of the shaft. There are the swing brake and the swing clutch, while at the boom end the swing pinion is attached. By engaging the swing clutch, the swing pinion is allowed to rotate about the ring gear. There, by engaging the turntable, the reversing of the motion is done by engaging either side L or R clutch to stop swinging. The swing brake is used. Next is undercarriage unit. This is also known as the crawler travel, known as crawler travel unit. The unit consists of two swivel trap assembly fitted with the driving sprocket and ideal sprocket, track roller and support roller. The whole of the track assembly is mounted on a track frame. There is a provision for adjusting the tension on the track near the idle of the assembly. This serves the following purpose: to support the whole machine. Number 3 is the number 1. Number 2 is to help in the marching of the machine. Number 3 is to help in steering the machine. Next one is front attachment. This unit consists of a boom, a dipper stick and a bucket. The bucket is rigidly attached to the front end of the dipper stick, while the dipper stick and the bucket combination is held by rope at the end, and the stick is supported at the other end by the crowd pinion. So apart from the front attachment, the next one is torque converter. So torque converter is an important component of mechanical power transmission system. This is mainly used when torque requirement fluctuates adaptively in equipment like excavator, dumper, etc. The working principle is the basic way. The two table fans are placed face to face and close to each other. One of the fan is connected to electrically supply line. As the fan blade rotates, the air at high velocity from the rotating fan impinging on the fixed blade on the other fan blade causes the flexibility. Theoretically, if there is no loss of power, both the fan blades should rotate at the same